In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a smooth zoom transition in Premiere Pro, so let's get to it. Here you can see I've already set up a sequence with two videos on the timeline, there's no transition, and we're going to create one right now. First thing we want to do is to create an adjustment layer. The way we do that is come to the project panel, then click on this new item button and select adjustment layer. Make sure it matches your sequence settings, in my case it's 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second, click OK. Then you'll see the adjustment layer appear in the project panel. Simply drag and drop it one track above the videos. Then open the effects panel and search for transform. Then add it to the adjustment layer. Now head over to the effect controls panel. And the first thing we want to do is to uncheck use composition shutter angle and manually increase the shutter angle as you see fit. This gives the motion blur to the transition. So the higher value you put, the more motion blur you will get. The maximum is 360 and I'm going to keep it at 360. Now I'm going to move the time indicator at the point of the cut between the videos. Then I'm going to click the stopwatch for scale to create a keyframe and set the value to 300 so it's nicely zoomed in. Now I'm going to move 5 frames to the left from the point of the cut. Then I'm going to click on this reset button to reset the scale value back to 100. And I'm going to move to the point of the cut again and move 5 frames to the right this time. And again click the reset button. Now we have 3 linear keyframes and I'm going to zoom into them like this. I'm going to right-click on the first keyframe to the left and select Ease Out. Then right-click on the last keyframe to the right and select Ease In. Now I'm going to expand this arrow to see value and the speed graphs of the animation, and we're going to improve the velocity of them. I'm going to use the speed graph, this one. That's why I'm going to expand this down to better see the graph. Now I'm going to drag and select the first keyframe here, and you'll see these tiny blue handles. I'm going to drag this one to the right all the way, just make sure that the line is straight. Then I'm going to drag and select the last keyframe and drag this handle all the way to the left. Again, make sure the line is straight. And that's how the graph should look in the end. So here, if we preview the animation, we should have a very nice and smooth zoom transition. And at this point, if the adjustment is like too long and too disturbing, you can simply cut it after we've done all the work. So I'm going to bring the start and end point of the adjustment layer like that. So here we have a tiny adjustment layer that you can duplicate and use for multiple transitions in your sequence. And here's the zoom transition. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new in this tutorial. Thank you guys for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.